Good morning, children. Today's class, trigonometric ratios of complementary angles. As I told earlier that this topic is deleted, but this knowledge is required, so some problems I will do for you. Trigonometric ratios of the complementary. The word complementary means what? When the two angles sum is equal to 90 degree, then we can call them as a complementary angle only, right? So here it is written here also, two angles are said to be complementary if their sum equal to 90 degree. So here angle B already 90 degree, then what is the concept from this complementary means? Angle A plus C equal to 90 degree only, definitely we know that because angle sum property, right? Angle A plus angle C is equal to 90 degree. They form a complementary pair there. Already angle B is 90 degree. Now what we have to do from this means, whatever we have learned the trigonometric ratios that we should write here, first is sin A, then cos A, then tan A, then cosec A, sec A, cot A. I'll talk about the first three only, then it will be easy for you. Sin A is opposite side by hypotenuse, so BC by AC, right? Then cos A equal to adjacent side by hypotenuse, then AB by AC, then tan A equal to BC by AB. Next, what is the next one? Cosec A, CK and cot A. That means the reciprocal of sine will be AC by BC. CK will be AC by AB. Now, cot A equal to AB by BC. So, already we have learned the trigonometric ratios like this only with the formulas. So, with respect to angle A, we have written. Now, I just want to write for sine C. What is the value for sine C there? Sine C, if you are writing, it is opposite side by adjacent side only. So, opposite side by hypotenuse. So, it is equal to AB by hypotenuse, that is AC, right? So, angle C is equal to 90 minus A only, right? Angle C is equal to 90 minus A. How we are getting this one? Because angle A plus angle C is equal to 90. Angle B is 90, that means the remaining two angles sum is equal to 90 only. Now my question is that I have written here sin C, right? So sin, instead of sin C, I can write as sin 90 minus A. Then also it is correct now because A plus C equal to 90. So sin C or sin 90 minus A, that is equal to AB by AC only. Right, sin 90 minus A equal to AB by AC. First we have calculated C, then C in terms of A we have written. So what is the value we got there? AB equal to, okay, AB by AC. Okay, now in the first case where we have calculated sin A, cos A, tan A, cosec and CK, cot A, where this AB by AC is coming, if you check, it is equal to cos A. If you check, it is equal to cos A. That means sin 90 minus A can be written as cos A. Sin 90 minus A equal to cos A only. I think you got the idea now. Once again, I'll repeat. Once you understood the cos and sin relation thoroughly, then you can go for the other one. Anyhow, it is not there in the syllabus. Still, this it is very helpful while solving the problems and all only. So, just to see once again, what we will write first? First, we know that angle B is equal to 90 degree. Then what is the next concept we know? Angle A plus C is equal to 90 degree. Now, based on the triangle, we know that what is sin A? Sin A, cos A, that is easy one for you that naturally every children will write when it is comes to A and all. So, sin A, cos A, tan A, cosec A, cot A, that is equation one part we have written. There is no doubt. Now, what is the next A? We are going to write about the sin C. Sin C means from this relation we know that it is 90 minus angle A only. So I am writing first sin C. Sin C, if you check the diagram, the opposite side is AB, hypotenuse is AC. Now what is the next change we have to make? Instead of C, what I will write there? 90 minus A. Clear? 90 minus A, I'll write. Now, AB by AC, I'm checking in A relation where it is. It is coming cos A. So, sin 90 minus A, it is equal to cos A. Once again, I'll write. What is the relation you got? We got sine 90 minus A equal to cos A. Sine 90 minus A equal to cos A. Now, again, we will go for the another relation. Tan and cot, let us check. Tan A equal to BC by AB. Okay. Tan A equal to BC by A. AB only. Now, you check tan 90 minus A. What is the answer? AB by BC. One, we have calculated tan A. That is BC by AB. And we checked what is tan 90 minus A. Then we got the answer AB by BC. But this AB by BC is having relation with the cot. Cot A value are equal to AB by BC. So, first I told that which relation? Sine as well as cos. Now, what is the relation you are getting? Tan when we are considering, if it is 90 minus A, then its value equal to cot A. Right? So, what is left now? Cosec and sec only. So, first let us see cosec A, AC by BC. What is the sec A? AC by AB. Then check here, what is cosec 90 minus A? Cosec 90 minus A is AC by AB, which is equal to sec. So, we are having another one more relation we are having, that is cosec 90 minus A equal to sec. So, now one more relation based on the complementary angle we got. So, what is the problem here means? We already learned sine, cos, tan are having the reciprocals with which one? Cosec, sec and cot. So, one relation we already got. Now, we are having another relation based on complementary angle. There, sine is having a relation with the cos. Tan is having a relation with the cot. Cosec is having a relation with the sec. When we learned reciprocal functions, what happened? Sine is having relation with the cosec, not cos. Understood? So, but when 90 degree complementary rule are coming, sine is having a relation with the cos, tan is having a relation with the cot, cosec is having a relation with the sec only. So, children will get confused here only because of the first formula what we learned based on the reciprocal one. There we learned sine, cos, tan one side, other side cosec, sec, cot. I told you learned like that only. So why we learned like that means cosec, sec, cot are the reciprocals of respectively sine, cos, tan. But when it comes to the complementary rule, sine is having a relation with the cos. Similarly, cos is having a relation with the sine only. But tan and cot, they're also correct only. Tan and cot is having reciprocal relation also. But cosec and sec also not having any reciprocal. Now we are having 90 degree complementary rules are coming. So that is why once we learn the formula, make it thorough, then only it will be easy. So what we learned from here means, sine 90 minus A when checked, it is equal to cos, right? Cos 90 minus A, if you check, BC by S, ABC by AC, there we'll get a sine. Tan 90 minus A, you will get it and it is equal to cot A only. But when we are taking cosec 90 minus A, it is similar to sec. Then sec 90 minus A, when we are checking, it is related to cosec. Similarly, cot 90 minus A is related to tan only. So, these are the relations we got. Once again, we have written here, sine 90 minus A equal to cos A. Then, tan 90 minus A equal to cot A. Sec 90 minus A equal to cosec. Similarly, the other side also we can write. When cos is having 90 relation, cos 90 minus A means it's sine A. Cot 90 minus A equal to tan A. Cosec 90 minus A equal to CK. So, all the 6 ratios we have written. But when you are learning 3, you can complete the remaining 3 only. So, first day we learned this side only. What is the first one? Sine 90 minus A, cos A. Tan 90 minus A, cot A. Sec 90 minus A, cosec A. Anything you can change according to the pattern I have written here. Now, what is the next change? Instead of sine, what I will write? Cos. So, answer will be sine. instead of tan, what I'll write? The right hand side cot we are having. So now left hand side cot we are having cot 90 minus A equal to tan A. Then sec 90 minus A equal to cosec. Cosec 90 minus A equal to sec A. So for all the values of the angle A lie between 0 to 90 only, we can hold. We can check for 0 and A 90 degree also it is true only, because some are undefined. Yes, you know that we are not talking about this one. This knowledge you should have when a complementary relation is coming. Sine is related with the cos, but tan is related with the cot. Sec is related with the cosec only. Let us see some example, then you can understand. Evaluate tan 65 divided by cot 25 only. First, what you have to check in this sum means, what is 65 and 25 sum? What is 65 and 25 sum? If you add 65, then 25, what is going to get there? It is 90. So there is a complementary relation between 65 and 25. Now, tan 65, we are keeping like that only. But cot 25, we can change it as a tan 65. How it is happening there? See, listen here. Cot 25, in the sense, we can write tan of 90 minus 25 only. Right, then only we can write it tan 65. So listen here, what we have written here, I'll go for the theory part. Sine 90 minus A equal to cos A. So instead of sine 90, what is the name comes? Cos. Now what is the angle here? A is there. So here also A you are getting. Now, with respect to the example, I will write now, sine 90 minus 30, right? Up to sine 90, what is the change should be written? It should be cos. Place of A, what is the angle we are having? 30. So, it will be cos 30. Once again, tan 90 minus 60, I am writing. Complementary relation of tan is which one? Cot. So, up to tan 90, the name changed to cot. But here, in place of A, what is the value? 60. So, it should be cot 60 only. I think you understood now. Now, listen. Cot A means tan 90 minus A. Actually, we have to evaluate only. So, we know the formula. When tan 90 minus A equal to, that is cot A only. So, what is the denominator? It is cot 25. Cot 25 means it is tan of 90 minus 25, isn't it? That means tan 65. After 65, how you got 90 minus 25 only? Okay, so that is why we are writing this tan 65. So here tan 65 by cot 25, what is the answer? We can write a tan 65 by tan 65, it is equal to 1 only. Now without thinking to the rule, what we can write, you tell me. First I will write tan 65. Right now cot 25 is there. So cot 25, we already understood that at 65 and 25 when we add, we will get a 90 degree only. So directly I can write 90 minus 25. So 90 minus 25, which is 65 only, but cot is having which is relation with the 90, tan. Okay, that is why tan 65 by 65, it is equal to 1 only. Now again, sin 3a equal to cos a minus 26, where a 3a is an acute angle, find the value of a only. See, sin 3a equal to cos of a minus 26, we cannot compare, because one side the ratio is sin, another side t ratio is cos only. When both the angles are same, both the t ratios are same, then only angle can be equal. So see, this is sin 3a. Sin 3a, how we can change it? We already know that sin and cos is the t ratio relations when we are talking about the complementary, right? So when we are getting 3a means the in place of a, that is 3a will be there, right? So for getting sin, what I should write? A cos 90. That is why this 3a can be changed to 90 minus 3a, then sin can be changed to cos only. Right, so both the side you got cos. So we can compare the angles now. Solve for a equal to 29 only. So now the question comes that only left side we can change, right side we cannot. Right side also you can change. Instead of cos, we can make it sine also on the right side. But here what happens, two terms are there. So children will do error while expanding with the minus bracket. So wherever one term is there, that side we will choose safely. Okay, one more question, let us see. Tan 48 degree, tan 23 degree, tan 42 degree, tan 67 degree, everything is evaluate only. What is the case here means we should group the terms where 90 degree is coming. So when I am taking 48, with the 23 it is not coming 90 only. So with the, which number it is coming? For 48 and 42 if you take, that is equal to 90. Similarly, 23 and 67 if we are grouping, then what is the answer we will get? It is equal to 90 degree. So two grouping we have to do here. That is, what is the one first term? Tan 48 with tan 42, then tan 23 and then tan 63. So you should identify whether we are getting sum equal to 90 degree only. So what is the next step we should write? Left hand side written here already. Tan 48, tan 23 is written. So instead of 42, we need a relation with which one? 48 only. So we can write 48 we are changing as 90 minus 48. So otherwise what we can write? Directly we can write it is cot 48. Directly we can write it is cot 48 because tan and cot are the T ratios. Similarly, tan 65, how we can write it directly? Cot 23 only. Understood this one? So tan 48, then instead of tan 42, it is cot 48. Instead of tan 67, it is cot 23. So like this, you can write first tan 48. We identified that it is having the relation when we are having 42. Then only 90 is coming. The other two I am not considering. Only these two I am considering. So tan 48. I just want to change this as a in terms of 90 degree. So 42 means it is 90 minus 48 only. Right. Now my writing here tan 42. If left side I have written tan, right side also I should write 90 minus 40 tan only. So up to tan 90, what you can write to tell me? It is equal to cot. Now in place of A, which angle is coming? 48. I think now you got the idea. Tan 48 into cot 48, how we are getting. One more example I'll go. That is which one? Tan 23 and tan 67. I'll make the group of that one. First I'll write which one? Tan 23. Then I have done the grouping with the tan 67, right? Now, what is the first step? 67, I'm changing as 90 minus 23. So, instead of tan 90, what I can write? Cot. In place of A, what is the value? 23. So, that is why tan 23 into cot 23 you are getting there. So this step I think you are clear now. Tan 48, tan 23, cot 48, cot 23. Now once we got this step, what is the relation of this one? Tan and cot are reciprocals only. See that one, how we are relating. First we are talking about a complementary rule. Now we are telling the first rule, what we have learned, cot reciprocal relation. So tan 48 into 1 by tan 48 I can write. That is why it will get cancelled here. Tan 48 and cot 48. Tan theta into cot theta. What is the value? Because cot theta can be written as 1 by tan theta. So tan tan will get cancelled. It is equal to 1 only. I'll write once again. Okay. You understood that tan 48 and cot 48 up to that? Okay. Now, what is the next step? Tan 48, I am keeping like that only. Tan 48. Now, instead of cot 48, what we can write? 1 by tan 48. So this tan 48, this tan 48 will get cancelled. That is why it is equal to 1 only. Similarly, here also, tan 23 and cot 23. What we can write? Tan 23 into 1 by tan 23. So it will get cancelled. Again, it is equal to 1 only. So the same rule, which rule we have applied? Tan and cot are the reciprocal rule. So two rules we are using this question. Which are the two rules? First rule is that complementary rule. The second one is reciprocal rule. That is why we are telling that first class is over, then and there only that formula should be learned. Second class you have learned the values, that formula, specific angles, values you must learn. Now we are learning the new one, that is complementary rule. So like this you have to learn. This is for knowledge sake I'm giving, and somewhere we will get application in the fourth exercise also. So you have to study actually the rules which we have learned today. This box, that is sine is having a relation with the cos when complementary rule is there, tan and cot are there, sec and cosec are there. But when it comes to the reciprocal, sine is having reciprocal relation with the cosec. And tan is having a reciprocal relation with the cot. But the sec is having the reciprocal relation with the cosec only. So don't confuse the both the ideas. Both ideas are different only. But one term, that tan and cot, is repeating with the same rule. Okay, one more question is there, I think. Okay, express cos 75, cot 75 in terms of the angle between 0 to 30 degree. That means this 70 degree we should bring in between 0 to 30 degree. Actually, cos 75 is there. Cos 75 we should bring in terms of the angle between 0 to 30. So 75 and 90, if you consider, 15 is the difference. So cos 75, can I change it to sin 15 now? Similarly, cot, already you know that cot is having complementary relation with which one? Tan only. So instead of 75, it became 15. When you are changing the angles, you know that T ratios also changed. That is the thing we have to remember. So what is the step we have followed here? Cos 75, 75 we changed as 90 minus 15. 90 minus 15, the value is 75 only. So instead of 75, it is equal to 90 minus 15. So cos 90 came. What is the name for cos 90? It is sine. A, in place of A, what is the value is coming? So that is equal to 15 only. Got? Next, cot 75 can be written as, first 75 we are changing, 90 minus 15 only. But we have considered up to cot 90, that is 10. And in place of A, what is the value? A equal to 15 only. So this is also another question based on this. But just when we are changing the angles, you can observe and see that here what T ratio names also changed. One more question from this. If ABC are the interior angles of a triangle ABC, prove that tan of C plus A by 2 equal to cot B by 2. A, B, C are the interior angles. What is the meaning of interior angles of the triangle? We already know that its angle sum is equal to 180 degree only. So angle A plus, angle B plus, angle C is equal to 180 degree. Now, in the question, you can see that both the left side and right side, it is equal to by 2 is there. So we are dividing both the side by 2. That is why dividing by 2 we have written. A by 2 plus B by 2 plus C by 2, it is equal to 180 by 2, that is 90 only, right? So A by 2 plus B by 2 plus C by 2 equal to 90 we got. Now what is the next step? If you check left side, we need A plus C on one side and A B on the other side only, right? So here we have taken as A plus C by 2. I'll keep here like this. A plus C by 2 because denominator is same, and other side it is 90 minus B by 2. Okay, now 90 minus B by 2 is there, here A plus C is there. Now go through the question. LHS we are having tan, RHS we are having cot. So I am taking both the side tan ratio, tan A plus C by 2, then tan 90 minus B by 2. Now you tell me tan A plus C by 2 left side we have got already, but right side it is cot only. So you tell me the name, what is tan 90? instead of tan 90, we can write cot. Now, in place of A, here B by 2. So, what is the answer we got? Cot B by 2. So, LHS equal to RHS only. Once again, we can go. What is the interior angle property of a triangle? All the sum of all the interior angle of a property, it is equal to 180 degree only. If you check the question, you can see that both the side you can by 2 property is coming, right? So when you are having by 2 property, we are dividing the equation with the by 2 only. So what is the equation we are getting? A plus B plus C whole divided by 2 equal to 180 by 2 only. Now, according to the question, we need A plus C on one side. So what we are doing? A plus C by 2. Already 180 by 2, we got 90 here. So 90 is there. And B by 2, we are taking to that side. So minus B by 2. Now, according to the question, tan we required. So, both the side we are applying tan. Taking tan ratio on both the sides. Okay. So, tan A plus C by 2, we cannot change anything because no 90 is there. But this side, RHS, if you see, tan 90 is there. Instead of tan 90, what we can write, it is cot. In place of angle A, we have B by 2. So, we are writing B by 2. Now, you check LHS and RHS of the question. What is the answer we are having? Tan C plus A by 2 equal to cot B by 2 only. Okay. So, the next topic, I think, okay. It's a trigonometric identity only. It will take time. So, listen carefully. One of the important topic only. Here, complementary rule we have learned, but it's deleted. So, just learn what is the relation between which two ratios. Sin 90 minus A means it should be cos A. Tan 90 minus A equal to cot A. Sec 90 minus A equal to cosec A. Then cos, like that when you are writing. Once you learned this three, then you can go for easily this side also. Just replacing the ratios and you will get the other ratios values only. So, learn here also the first left side. Then you go for the right side, three formulas only. So, here this is the complementary rule. Complementary rule, just for knowledge sake, you should study and you should learn the formula. Formula, no excuse only. Applications, you can leave the questions only. Now, what is the next topic? We have to learn about trigonometric identities. Trigonometric identities, just if you speak just an identity, you will remember that algebra also we have learned identities, A plus B whole square, A plus C whole square, A minus B whole square, like that. The same way, trigonometry is also having identities. What is the meaning of the identity? An equation is called an identity when it is true for all the values of the variables involved. Similarly, an equation involving trigonometric ratios of an angle is called a trigonometric identity. It is true for all the values of the angles involved. So, when we are doing A plus B whole square, what is the answer? A plus B whole square equal to A square plus 2AB plus B square. Any value you go for A and B. Any value you go in for A and B, the remaining LHS and RHS, always it is true only. Same as case with the trigonometric identities also. Whatever angle value you take, both the side LHS and RHS, it is equal only. So, that is why it is also called an identity. It is true for all the values only. So, one of the important property of this chapter, and moreover, this exercise only the one which is difficult here, but before doing this exercise we need to learn three formulas. That three formulas you have to make it thoroughly, so it required time only. So I think next class we can go complementary angle. Today we can stop that much only. So trigonometric identity I'll teach tomorrow only. So, trigonometric identities means like algebra identities only. It is also true for any angle. So, with this today's class, I'm winding up. Thank you.